My name's Harry Wilson.
My name's Kenny Quittell.
My name is Virginia Baptiste. I'm from the Osoyoos Indian Band in Over, BC.
My name is Harry Lucas. I'm actually 64 years old.
My name is Tsebeyot from the house of Tsebeyot of Ajida.
My name is Nunkaithka. I come from the people of Haida Gwaii. My English name is Douglas Wilson. In academic circles, I'm known as Dr. Douglas Wilson.
I went to Port Alberni Residential School, 1959 to 1970.
I went to the residential school in Cranbrook, BC. My first year was 1955. I went until 1963.
I'm a survivor of the Edmonton Indian Residential School. I was there from 1957 to 1961.
At age 5, I was kidnapped by terrorists in a gunboat. The RCMP had this gunboat. It was a RCMP boat with a gun mounted on it to gather children from villages.
We were segregated right from the day one. I remember in September we were all on a beach and we were all given numbers.
When I first got to school in Cranbrook, we were all given a number. My number was 54, and my underwear, my socks, my uniform, my towels, everything that I had a number. It was 54 on there. And all the girls had their own numbers. And if you were caught with somebody else's number, you got whipped for that.
We weren't allowed to have books, and we weren't allowed to read. If you were caught reading any kind of a book or a magazine, you were punished. There was a severe punishment that way.
The kids who told on us got preferential treatment, whereas the children who sang their songs and spoke their language were punished constantly for any little thing, for even for laughing.
It was always hard for us to tell one another we love you, because we were taught to love was wrong. They told us the love was wrong, that was the devil's work. But yet, these priests and nuns could hug and kiss. And we couldn't even hug our own brothers. We couldn't even hold them and tell them we loved them. It took me a lot of years before I was able to tell my boys I loved them.
3 years it took me to realize it, though, you know, of torture and pain, you know, being strapped at a young, you know, I lost my childhood when I first got there and never knew what it was like to have parents. Still hurts. Sorry about that.
Sorry, you don't have to apologize.
But I never knew my mother, still don't today.
I couldn't remember any good times that were there, because I was being punished for things I'd never done.
Like what kind of punishment?
Punishment by restraining me to the bed, by putting a restrainer on me and holding me down in the bed. I had bed problems, as wetting the bed, and they would tie me in bed and put an electric underneath my sheet, so that when I did wet, I would electrocute myself.
Did they put you in a hospital?
Yes, they did. Well, yeah, they gave me some drugs or something like that.
What kind? What happened to you?
I don't know what kind of drug it was.
What happened to you when they gave you the drugs?
Hey, yeah, put me in there, like a padded room. Padded room, like? I was strapped down.
That was after you reported the girl?
Yeah.
Finding the girl's body?
Yeah.
I'd seen them burn hands of kids when they're 3 years old and 5.
with a little spike in their hand and like that, like a shock thing.
Electric shock?
Yeah.
Device? Why did they shock the kids?
Because the kids wouldn't listen to the Catholic priest.
He used it on my brother's penis. He electrocuted his penis there till my brother passed out. And he was laughing, brother. My brother said he was laughing while he was doing it. You'd like to see him in pain, I guess.
And then the police force, I was involved in a few investigations regarding the victims of a residential school where one particular individual had went home in the summer and learned how to speak his own language, and his dad had taught him how to carve. And he went back to school. He continued doing this, speaking his own language and carving. And the teacher caught him and took his knife away and broke his carving up. And he took a pencil and he drove it right through his hand. And you still see the scar where he drove the pencil right through his hand.
Then there was other times where they put us in a tub, and then they had a bucket of snakes, you know, them black and yellow snakes. And they throw that in the tub while we're having a bath. And the snakes are, they can't stand that hot water. They try and crawl all over our bodies, trying to get away from that hot water. And they'd all just curl up because they die immediately. And that was some of the horrifying things that they'd done to us to discipline us to keep quiet.